All right, what's going on? Hello, everyone. Welcome back to Chris Allen Recap number 28. So, we have quite a little bit to go over, and one of those is going to be some changes coming. But before I get into that, let me, as I always do, explain the image we are all looking at. So, today's at least first topic, because there's at the very least, two we're going to get to, has to do with entertainment. So, what does this mean? Basically, I heard recently, well, not recently, but over time, I've heard that, oh, why do entertainers get so much money? All they do is, you know, make us laugh, or they only, you know, work for this much time, this amount of days, this and that, and they make millions and millions of dollars, you know. It's crazy. How can entertainers be paid that much? And first of all, the people who say that are probably salty as hell, me included. But second of all, there's a lot of different ways you can tackle that and kind of think about it. The first way, and the way many people go at it, is with the question of why do people that don't provide an essential service like a medical care professional, a doctor, let's say, a lawyer. Well, a lawyer's not really, you know, needed, but sometimes they are, I guess. But, like, something essential like a doctor or a fucking, I don't know, a firefighter or something like that. Like, why are these things that are, like, important to society, more so than entertainment, paid vastly less than entertainment and kind of valued less? And value's the big, you know, spoiler alert here. But that's the main question. Now, tackling this from this perspective, you could say it's simply based on what people value entertainment at. So obviously, you know, our taxes are the things that go into firefighting and stuff like that, and not doctors. Sometimes that's, well, most of the time now that's private. If I think all of it is private, I'm pretty sure. I'm not familiar with the medical care system in the United States. All I know, it sucks, but in general, we kind of leave it up to a manager of sorts or a CEO of a company to kind of dictate how much that company gets paid. So let's say the CEO of like a medical company of doctors, like let's say, what's here in New York? Mount Sinai, right? Let's say we have Mount Sinai and they have doctors. The CEO basically tells the salary of the doctors there, right? It's controlled by a single person. Now, contrast that to entertainment. Entertainment, the single leading person, the person who, for the most part, unless you have a manager or a parent company, the person who really controls it all is the creator. It's the person who does the entertaining. So all the money funnels into them. And sometimes, you know, even now with YouTube, we have entertainers. I would say the biggest example that's very obvious and overt with it is Philip DeFranco. We have entertainers like him, and although he's a news channel, I would also argue he is entertainment, because you could get your news from elsewhere. You know, he has people under him that he pays, but he probably gets the majority of the money, because he's the leader, which is also the creator. So entertainment, you know, however much people value the entertainer is how much money goes into it. So how much money do you think realistically goes into Mount Sinai? It's probably a shit ton. It's probably millions, if not, you know, well, probably not billions, but who knows? It's New York City, Manhattan. But for sure, tens of millions of dollars probably go into Mount Sinai. Now, the CEO or owner of Mount Sinai probably gets paid near what you would expect entertainers to be paid, and then he gives off, you know, some of the money to probably investors or workers. But the problem is there's so many people under who the money is going to for the most part. Slash insurance companies probably too, but in general, that's how it works in entertainment. And that's one way I've kind of realized recently of like, you know, why do entertainers get paid so much? It's because there's no one, for the most part, over them or under them that they have to really shill out money to. And if it is under them, they're still taking a majority of the cut. Now, that's the first way, and that's kind of the way I just logicked literally on the spot right now. What I actually wanted to talk about was the second way, which I thought of recently, and I was like, damn. You know, if the entertainers, or not entertainers, if the people like the firefighters and the doctors got paid an entertainer-level salary, which let's just say, you know, let's be generous, right? Let's say a million. Let's say, because most entertainers are making way more than that, right? Let's just say every doctor and every lawyer and every firefighter or every essential job got paid $1 million. First of all, everyone would want to be a doctor, and if that was, you know, the case, you know, I think personally the requirements would become stricter, most likely. If not, that's crazy. But if it doesn't, let's just say everyone wants to become a doctor and the requirements to become a doctor don't change, it doesn't become harder, and all the doctors get paid $1 million, which is unrealistic, and I'll go over that in a second, but all the doctors get paid $1 million, then at that point, we'll be fucking bankrupt. No one can afford to pay a doctor. Like, it's gonna not work out. We can have entertainers, because only some of the entertainers actually make it and get paid that amount, and they're the lucky ones. And I explained why they got paid that amount with the first, you know, argument I had, which is it's how much you value it, and the money goes basically all to them. So that's the explanation of why they get all their money. And now the tackling argument I'm taking on is, why don't the other, you know, professions get that money that are not entertainers, that are quote-unquote more valuable or more necessary than entertainers? It's because if all of them did, then, you know, they wouldn't fucking be able to exist, because they'd bankrupt like any company, or you wouldn't be able to afford them. So, now obviously you can make the argument, maybe some of them are underpaid now, and I totally agree with some of them, but that's a whole new can of worms. Now the other argument is, okay, obviously it's unrealistic to pay all of the people in a single profession $1 million salary, or basically equal salary across the board. And I would agree. I would say, more often than not, as this is America and we love competition and capitalism, there shouldn't be a cap onto how much someone should or could get paid, right? I think someone should or could get paid however much that they think they're valued and however much they can work out of someone, like the entertainers. The fact of the matter is, if you become a doctor, or, and this is me guessing here, I don't know the exacts of it, but if you become a doctor in my mind, right, let's say you become a doctor, you have like, and you're a good doctor too, let's just say you have a $200,000 salary a year, you're like a surgeon or something. At that point, your salary might go up if you stay there a couple years, but it's never going to go into the millions. I think there should be some surgeons that are at the top of their craft, that have been there for years. You know what you're getting with them. They have, you know, beyond excellence at what they do. They should be valued very high. And who knows, it might be like that for some of them, but you really don't hear about it. Now, I think that's how it should be with some things, but then, you know, it kind of becomes blending into the line of celebrity, and that gets a little because now we're trying to blend things. But in general, I think that's the way it should go. And I do agree with the general argument of like, hey, why do entertainers get paid so much? I understand the argument. I understand in reality why it happens. It's because people can throw their money at whatever they want, however much they want, and the money goes literally to the person and no one else for the most part. I'm going to keep repeating that so many times. But yeah, that was my general thought. Like, if everyone got paid, when an entertainer got paid, it wouldn't work out. So in the same way in the entertainment field, you have entertainers that make millions upon millions. That's not every entertainer. People think, oh, you know, I can become an entertainer, I can make millions. No, bitch, you can't. Just like me, I'm sitting here fucking a failed reject. So would probably you, and the majority of people would probably be. Now, it's not to, well, you know, kind of is a bad thing, but not to say that's a bad thing, I'm not trying to insult anyone, but it's just a matter of the fact of it's competition. And there's no competition when it comes to lawyer, well, there is when hiring, but there's no, like, price competition for the most part. When it comes to lawyers, firefighters, doctors, and stuff like that, they generally have a salary and you can't go above that, even if you should be valued at more in most scenarios. Because again, the main thing I was thinking about is, okay, the argument isn't even valid of why don't we pay, like, lawyers and doctors more, which they should probably get paid more, but you can't pay every lawyer and doctor more because it's going to hurt the whole system. The same way, not every entertainer makes $1 million. Not every doctor should be making $1 million either. Some of them probably should. Maybe. Depends how much you value your health, which I would understand throwing money at your health. I don't understand throwing money at entertainers, but people do it anyway. I don't, though. But anyway, that's basically the first part of this whole thing and what the picture was about. It was about entertainment and just, you know, why people question it and kind of the thinking behind it. And those are my, like, two arguments for it. Or three. I don't fucking remember. But that's the first part. Second part is me explaining what's going on with the Chrisan recap. So, I've received recently some constructive criticism about the Chrisan recaps and that they were coming out too often. So, I've taken that constructive criticism and I've kind of altered what I'm doing now. So, in general, I'm not going to say for sure the Chrisan recaps are going away per se, because I might still do them, I might not. But they're definitely not going to come out like hotcakes, like I was starting to do them. Because originally, my whole plan for the Chrisan recaps was I want to share my opinion and what's going on with me, right? So I kind of hit two birds with one stone. But going over time, I kind of realized that the Chrisan recaps could obviously still be me sharing my opinions, but for the most part, they should be more centralized on me. So I've recently done a new. I wouldn't even call it a series. Maybe I would, but I'm not putting them into a channel or a playlist on YouTube, so I'm not gonna call it a series. I've done a new idea called My Opinion on Stuff. And, you know, what you see is what you get. My literal opinion on fucking anything I feel like sharing my opinion about. So it's very similar to the Chris Allen recap, and there might be some overlap because the Chris Allen recap, like I said, is my opinions on things, but also sometimes about news kind of related to me, which I'll get into soon. I'll get the news related to me. But I want the Chris Allen recaps mostly to be news relating to me, but it could be my opinions on stuff, while I want the my opinions of stuff mostly on opinions of different things, but that stuff could also be related to me. So basically, there might be some overlap, but Chris Allen recaps, more about me. Opinion stuff, more about my opinions on other bullshit, but they could overlap. So that's basically what's happening in the future. So for those fans of Chrisan recaps, I mean, they're not totally out. You know, I might do more in the future if I just feel really bad, because that's usually when I do them. It's talking about myself now though, and maybe some opinions. But if you want more Chrisan talking about stuff and opinions, first of all, please tell me what you want me to talk about. And second of all, I have the opinion videos now that I'm starting to make. But that concludes the second part of this Chris Allen recap. I think I said 28. And now the third part. So, the third part is the news about me. So, Twitch has been fucking me. I made a video about that. Twitch is super fucking annoying. But, ironically enough, aside from that, and aside from me quitting a job that I had for a week, you know, it's going pretty bad. It was really bad for a long time. But right now, I'm actually in just like chillax mode. I feel like the wave has stabilized. The wave is not in low tide. I'm not really sad right now. I kind of feel indifferent, bordering on like sometimes in a good mood, which is good. You know, I'm not too sad. I feel the sadness coming though. It's definitely on the horizon. It's coming in. I see the tsunami, well, the opposite tsunami of the low tide coming in where I'm gonna hit a low point. It's coming, but it's not here yet. So for now, I'm pretty okay. I'm not good, but I've been not in a bad mood, and I've been pretty, like, you know, just relaxed. Now, excuse me. For those of you who don't know about what I'm talking about, I had a job as a medical scribe. And I worked for this medical scribe company in California, and I'll tell my opinions about that. So, I got the job, it was completely online. I had it for about a week worth of training. And this has been probably the most professional job I've had so far in my life, and maybe forever, because I don't know if I'll get a job as professional, but it was professional with an asterisk. It was professional in the sense that they were trying to be as professional as they could, because they were kind of a new startup company. And they definitely had the money for it. Like, they definitely make money, because, you know, they're with medicine. So, you know, you're gonna be making guank with that. But online, this job is so shitty. They basically had their training like fully just like, hey, we're gonna explain to you what to do. The explanations were super fucking confusing and it was super ass. The videos were outdated. The training was outdated. I didn't have access to the full training materials. The people didn't respond. And because it's over online, I had a lot of tech problems that they never answered. And I had to basically jury rig a fucking solution that didn't even work half the time for most of the problems I had. But in general, without revealing too many details, it was pretty shitty, and I quit that job. And despite quitting it, I'm happier because I quit it. Because also, I was making under $11 an hour because of being a contractor and how taxes work with that. And it was just terrible for the amount of work that I was expected to do, as well as the lack of good training that I was given to do it. It was really fucking bad. I feel really bad for all the people in that job and medical scribes in general. You guys have to do a lot of work, and I hope you get paid and get benefits, because that fucking job did not give me benefits either. But they sent me chocolates, and I am very happy for that. And that's why I will not try and speak too badly of them, because they didn't do wrong by me with those fucking chocolates. But anyway, yeah, I mean, just general mental health check-in. I'm okay. I'm pretty good for now. I'm just riding the wave. I'm a little bored, but I'd rather be bored and having nothing to do than having a bad time. You know, to me, I'm very thankful to not be forced to do anything. I really like freedom as much as I'll complain about it. I really do enjoy it. But yeah, I think that's all we're gonna go over today. We got the entertainment thing out of the way. Like in the future, that would probably be an opinion video about entertainment. The only thing I don't know is how I would do a follow-up, like, oh, my new opinion on entertainment, or my new opinion on entertainment if I like change it 3 times. I mean, I don't know. Who knows? But yeah, the Chrisanne recaps and opinion videos. Basically, the opinion videos are birthed from the Chrisanne recaps, and Chrisanne recaps might be more centralized towards me, but there could be overlap, and I've been okay recently. I'm not starting the job search yet because that's definitely gonna get me depressed about myself. And I'm kind of waiting on Planet Fitness to hopefully hire me back so I could just hopefully do something where I know I can do it at a decent level. But yeah, that's that. I hope you enjoyed. And yeah, don't expect another one of Chrisanne recap so soon, if at all, but we'll see. I'm out of here.